Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot with day 11 of the Skyrim Beast Battle Arena. We are on our third quarter-final fight, just one more to go. Tomorrow, the Sabercat versus the Frost Troll, and that will decide our semi-finalists. But before then, Falmer Gloomlurker against the Dragon Priest. Once more, we have a clear underdog, as you can see in your votes at the bottom. But as we've seen before, the underdog can prevail. It's not happened in a while. 30 of you, and myself personally, kind of want the underdog to pull it off. Pull it off, because damn it, here in Britain we love an underdog. Let's see if he can make it. Let's meet the contestants. In the red kind of area corner bit, we have, I went a bit farther, we have the Falmer Gloomlurker. He decided to go topless today, mainly because he wants to show off to all the female farmers out there, but otherwise, because of that, he kind of wants a bit more mobility, a bit more flexibility. He's taking some sort of interpretive dance classes, get some more mobility around the dance floor. And the fight floor, if that was a thing, which it's not. Seems to have opted for a bow and arrow today. Not sure if that will help or not, but if you can get into a good position, maybe you can ping some arrows from a distance. He's a good looking guy, you don't know that because of the mask, but he does actually look like Brad Pitt under there if you just ignore the mouth and nose region. Imagine Brad Pitt with the nose and mouth of a Falmer, and you're pretty much there. There he is. He's beautiful. He's ready to fight. Mr. Falmer Gloomlurker. We shall call you Gloomy. How are you feeling? He's actually talking to me in code via his eyes, but you can't tell because of the helmet. What are you going to do? In the blue corner, let's meet his contestant. It's the Dragon Priest called Mahumatoto, because that sounds like a priestly dragon-y type name. He has blue crap flying into his nose, and he's very angry about something, probably because his feet are getting a bit hot on this metal grating. Mr. Dragon Priest, you've done well. You're a top favourite for this competition now that the giant's out. How do you feel? You know what? Every NPC in this game is unbelievably rude. It's almost like they can't hear me talking. Whatever. Let's get this fight on the go. Cue some epic music. You know the drill by now. In 3, 2, 1, ding ding ding. And then Dragon Priest straight away with a flametronic summon. The Falmer is backing off, firing away arrows from the distance. Pinging those arrows. Bing! Takes down the Flametron and is now just beating away on the Dragon Priest. The Dragon Priest who's not getting many attacks in actually from this distance. Oh! And the Falmer seems to be switching. Oh! The Falmer goes down. He was a worthy contestant. That's one angry Dragon Priest. I do feel that the Falmer's choice to use a bow and arrow probably didn't help him, but the fact is, he wasn't going to do much in this fight anyway. I think we all know that is a dramatic shot of a dead Falmer right there. I think most of us did see this coming. Unfortunately, the Dragon Priest, the favourite, has gone through. But tomorrow there's always a chance for the underdog, because they're both pretty much underdogs. Will the Frost Troll or the Sabercat make it through to the next round? You guys, as always, leave a vote at the bottom, like the post that sort of describes the one that you want to vote for, and we shall find out in the next battle who will make it through to face the Dragon Priest in the second of our semi-finals. See you then, guys. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. I've got the score sheet up now, you can see what's going on, and I shall see you then. Much love, cheers, bye-bye.